Are you wondering what air pressure to use with your airbrush and why it's really important to get it right? I'm Warwick from Harder and Steenbeck, and here's our need to know basics. Stick around to the end of the video where I'll give you my top tip on the topic. Firstly, when you look at your pressure gauge, you'll see two sets of numbers, one big, one small. One of them is in bar and the other one is in PSI. They're just different units of measurement, and I'll use both in this video so that everybody gets the information that they need. Now, if you're a beginner and you just want to have one setting that you put into your compressor that you know is going to make your airbrush work okay and good for most circumstances, set it to just under 30 PSI or just under 2 bar, and you'll be good to go with almost any brand of airbrush and almost any type of airbrush. Going past that, if you want to think about what air pressure really does, it's helpful to think about it as energy. Okay, so it's the energy that goes into the airbrush to make it function, and it does kind of two things. First of all, it governs how fast your airbrush will spray. And secondly, it has an impact on how finely the paint is atomized. When you understand this, you understand that there's actually a lot more that you can do with air pressure. For example, if you know you're going to do some really fine detail work where it would be really helpful if your airbrush's delivery would just slow down a little so that you got more time to watch that last highlight develop before you decide to shut it off, turn your air pressure down a little bit, maybe down to 20 PSI or somewhere around about 1 1/3, 1 1/2 bar. And it'll just take a little bit of speed off your airbrush's delivery. That's a really useful point when you're doing some work that you might otherwise find a little stressful because you want to make sure that you don't put down too much color. The second point where it's really useful to play around with how much your atomization is when you're trying to create textures. Now, why would you do this? If you're trying to make a stony texture, or perhaps you've got something where you're looking for a slightly textured skin kind of feel. If you turn your air pressure right down to below 1 bar or below 15 PSI and start playing around with those numbers, you'll find that your airbrush can deliver these wonderful stipples, which is tiny little dots where the atomization is not so fine that you can't see the dots. It becomes quite coarse so that you can see the dots. And it's really useful when you're trying to create textured finishes. Particularly when you're doing stone, it's really helpful to have a mixture of stipple sizes that you can really control finely where you put them with the airbrush, much more so than you could by flicking a paintbrush, for example. My top tip about air pressure with the airbrush is, again, when you think about it as a form of energy in the airbrush. Now, the number one enemy of every airbrusher is tip drying. When you get paint drying on the tip of your needle. And the analogy I'm going to give you is, imagine two towels hanging out to dry on a washing line, one on a windy day and one on a day where it's not so windy. Now, which one's going to dry out first? It's going to be the towel on a windy day, right? So if you're doing a lot of airbrushing and you really want to try to mitigate tip dry, don't use more air pressure than what you need to get the atomization level that you want. The more air that you've got rushing out over that needle tip, the quicker you're going to dry the paint on it, particularly when you're doing very fine work where the flow of paint is actually pretty slow because you're making very small trigger openings. Typically, when you've got less paint, you need less energy to atomize it as well. So when you're using very small trigger openings, you'll tend to find that the amount of air pressure you need to atomize that small amount of paint is not so great. In other words, when you're doing very fine work, just have a play with turning your pressure down a little bit. And what you'll find is you'll still get that reliable delivery, you'll still get good atomization, but the tip dry will just take that much longer to form, and then airbrushing just becomes that much easier. Make sure you subscribe to our channel, and in the next video, I'm going to be talking about how to correctly use the airbrush trigger.